Good evening. My name is Bond. James Bond.
Open Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Open Gangnam Style.
Ruby. Ruby.
Oh, healing.
I feel a slight stiffness coming on.
Oh, I'm ready, Hilly.
I'm sorry, Ruby, but my will is feeling a bit nilly tonight. And, can't do it with a willy that's nilly. Willy's got to be willing. But Hilly has a willy nilly tonight. Sorry.
Oh my. Oh. Millie's never quite felt this sort of sensation before. Ah!
Hello everyone and welcome to my review. Sorry it's been a bit late, but been busy. So, today we are going to be reviewing the sixth James Bond movie, and the one and only Bond movie to star everyone's favourite Bond, George Lazenby. So, the basic plot of On Her Majesty's Secret Service is James Bond rescues this woman called Tracy from... I think she's about to, like, kill herself, like, drown herself at the beginning. Then he rescues her. Then when he meets her at her hotel, he's interrogating her because he's trying to uncover the plot of Blofeld's allergy schemes. Which involves Bond going undercover to try and stop him, and he asks Tracy to get information. Meanwhile, Tracy's father... persuades Bond, asks Bond to basically marry her, give her someone to kind of create balance in her life, because he feels that she's sort of a bit lost in the world, that she needs some man to sort of dominate her, so to speak. So there's kind of two different threads in the plot. But yeah, no, this is the sixth Bond movie, and... yes, this is on a Majesty's Secret Service. Thank you. Thank you, producers. You did it. You got Bond back on track. Wow. What an amazing piece of cinema. On a Majesty's Secret Service is one of those films where, you know, you can't help but not like it. What's not to like? Well, there are problems, but I'll mention that later on. First of all, they've got rid of all the silliness. This is sort of a very serious Bond film, like the most serious Bond film since Goldfinger. And, you know, that was like three movies before this. Yes, it feels very different, not just in terms of the fact that, you know, we have George Lazenby as opposed to Sean Connery, but also the tone is really quite different because, you know... we have a love story, and this isn't just one of those random things where Bond, you know, he sees her, like, a woman for, you know, that afternoon, and then they have a bit of a whatchamaflip, and then he moves on to the next one. This is a proper love story. Bond, this is the first time Bond properly falls in love, and it is beautiful to watch. Seeing this, you go, okay, this is different. I mean, there's a nice montage, like, 30 minutes into the movie when... you see Bond and Tracy sort of falling in love, and it's really, really nice to watch. I really do love those scenes, and with Louis Armstrong's song as well, that's really nice. I also love the tone of this movie. The tone of this movie, serious. It's not like gritty or anything, you know, there is some light relief and light humour, but at its heart there is a serious kind of ground to the story. There's a nice balance in the tone, you know. There are times when it can be quite funny and nice and charming, but it can be quite hard and rough and serious. It is a true work of cinema. I mean, it's wonderfully crafted. The direction by Peter Hunt, new director, Peter Hunt is a masterful director. I wish he would come back. I wish he would have come back to do another Bond film, because Honor, Majesty, Secret Service was, you know, is a masterpiece. It is a masterpiece. And, so, you know, you really get the sense that there is a tension in the story. Like, you're waiting for, you know, Bond to uncover this from the threat of Blofeld. But you're also sort of waiting to see what would happen in the love story. So there are two different plot threads, which are really both quite interesting, and they flow really nicely. It's not like one outweighs the other. They are both consistent, and they flow really nicely. I think they do. Towards the beginning, they focus quite a lot more on the love story. Because Tracy, there is a section of the movie where Tracy doesn't actually appear very much, like during the middle. She appears sort of the beginning sections and towards the end. But during the middle, her presence is sort of absent. She's not in the movie in much of the middle. Yes, so let's talk about some of the positives. Wow, as I said, the direction is superb. I think this is one of the Bond movies where the dialogue really, the writing really vamped it up, like, because they were really ambitious with the love story. So some of those scenes between Bond and Tracy, the dialogue is really good. And I love watching those scenes. Every time I go back to this film, it's great. Production design and cinematography are stunning. Ken Adams' production design continues to impress me. Don't know if it's quite as good as the production design on the previous film, but the cinematography is great. It's great to look at. Even nowadays, it's great to look at. I mean, it's 1969. It's great. It's still great to look at. And yeah, you really believe, you know, you really feel the seriousness. Like, with the action sequences, the seriousness, you know, it's great. Like, features one of the best pre-credit sequences of the entire series, the fight on the beach, which is really good. Kind of spoiled with a few cringeworthy moments, such as George Lazenby's delivery of the line, "My name is Bond, James Bond." God. And this never happened to the other fella. What the hell? I know that you were trying to reference Connery, but you didn't need to do an in-reference. What was the bloody point? Oh, screw it, might as well mention him. he is Bond in this movie. To be honest, George Lazenby is an utter twit. There, I said it. George Lazenby is a complete twit who knows nothing about acting, was never an actor before this, but pretty much know next to nothing about the previous movies either. You know, he was completely chosen out of the blue. I agree with Jack McCullough. It was kind of like, eeny, meeny, miny, mo, catch a tigger by the toe. Oh, yeah, let's use him. I know that the replacement might not have been able to have stood up to Connery, and wouldn't have been able to have been better than Connery, but they could have at least picked somebody who was an actor. I mean, what the hell? I mean, Lazenby, the problem for me is that he has no personality. He has no screen presence. His charisma is weird. Like, he looks either far too happy, or he just has a very emotionless delivery. Like, when he's like, "Oh, I think we'll enjoy it more without that." And it's like, "I was always told mistakes can be remedied between friends, even lovers." Like, why would you say that in a happy tone? That just doesn't work. I mean, it doesn't help that some of the dialogue was kind of, you know, like, "Well, this never happened to the other fella." Seriously. And when he's like, "My name's Bond, James Bond," which is thankfully the only time he says the line. My God. It is cringeworthy to watch. And you see him when he's going around as Sir Hillary and he's posing, you know, posing all these girls. I mean, he apparently was a male model, like, but really? I don't really see it. How could... Is he really that attractive? Like, if there are any female members watching this video, please comment down below. Did you think in this movie that Lazenby looks attractive? I don't see it. If I were gay, I wouldn't go for him. Sorry, Lazenby, but yeah. Actually, yeah, so, I mean, Lazenby, it's just such a bizarre casting choice. I mean, he's okay in the action scenes, I guess. His best piece of acting is towards the end of the film, when Tracy dies. Which, oh, spoilers for all these reviews. Also, Dianna Rigg as Tracy. Wow. She is amazing in that role. I mean, I kind of wish that she had more to do, though. I kind of wish that she was in the movie during the middle as well. Like, but it doesn't bother me. I like, you know, seeing her at the beginning and then, like, looking forward to seeing her in the end. I'm like, oh, yeah, Tracy. You know, we haven't seen her for quite a while in the movie. She's fantastic, and her chemistry with Lazenby is surprisingly believable, considering Lazenby's really wooden performance. And as a result, you know, Dianna Rigg is the standout performance of the entire film. You know, because, you know, she has that... believability. She really has a kind of, she has a kind of stubbornness, but at the same time she has a kind of innocence as well. Like, you know, she's kind of like her father Draco, who is played really well by Gabrielle Ferzetti, as he sort of says, she kind of feels, I think he sort of mentioned something about her not really being, she's kind of lost in life, and you know, she needs a man to kind of dominate her. And Tracy's a really well developed character. She's not just a Bond girl. She is a character. You only live twice. Take note. This is how you develop a Bond girl. And this is how you do it well. Tracy is one of the best Bond girls ever. And, you know, her character, you know, at first she's sort of like, why do you persist in rescuing Mr. Bond? Like, as if she doesn't give a crap about him. And she doesn't even say thanks for him. But then she soon realises that she falls in love with this man. I mean, yeah, it's Lazenby. It's George Lazenby, but... still, he's playing Bond, so there you go. It might have looked a bit weird with Connery, because Connery was getting older, but... yeah, she's superb, and her death is just absolutely harrowing. It's really, really emotional, and for me, I kind of think... I've said this to a few people, I think that this, on Her Majesty's Secret Service... is the very sort of the first emotional Bond film. That's really kind of the first sort of big emotion, where the emotions are run quite high, and this is sort of because of Tracy's death and like the love story, and it all really, and you know, Bond gets married. This is a really unorthodox Bond film. Bond gets married at the end, and you know, it's it's, although the proposal scene is a bit cringeworthy. I mean, it's not the... I mean, it's kind of nice and romantic. You know, they're in the barn, and, you know, they're lying on each other. She's lying on him, and it's just the way Lazenby delivers the line. He's like, I'm never going to find another girl like you. Will you marry me? Why would you ask her like that? Obviously, you know, they're acting, but, well, Lazenby isn't, but... oh, but, no, the wedding scene is really nice, and is a nice little sort of... It, you know, if it was the last movie that they would have ever made, then it would have been a nice end to the series. But obviously, I'm so glad they didn't end on Her Majesty's Secret Service, because there's so much more to give after that movie came out. Yeah, so Tracy's death is really sad. And, you know, got to talk about the locations. The locations are really good. They range from London to the... I don't know where the beach is. I can't actually remember. And they go to the Alps, which is really quite nice. It's a very different location, and that sort of allergy research base, and they're sort of testing on the girls, and I thought that was quite an interesting way to go. I think the plot is really well thought out, and obviously Fleming really thought out the plot really well, and the movie is paced very well. Like how we kind of, I like how kind of the beginning is kind of building up, like building the love story up and then getting on with the main mission. And it's a different sort of style of Bond film. It's not like they're not sticking to the same sort of formula as they did in the previous five films, but well, they do, but they have the love story, so they've got to add more time, which is sort of like, you know, this movie is longer. This movie is nearly 2.5 hours long, so it's insanely long, but I enjoy every minute of it. I mean, yeah, granted, there could have been a couple of scenes you could have cut out, you know, gone to the cutting room and thought, okay, what can we lose? Because I do think towards the middle, there is a section which could be taken out. And I know that maybe if you said this to the director, he probably thought, actually, no, that kind of needs to be in there because we need to show, like, that they're being tested. But to be honest, you know, for me, the scenes that drag are when Bond actually goes around and as Sir Hillary, and he's, like, wooing all the other girls. I mean, to be honest, I mean, the fact that you have the love story, you don't really need to do that. You don't really need to have Bond going around and wooing every single female, you know, patient. Because the love story is so sort of pure and tender, you don't need that. It just feels like a bit of a pointless addition. It's not like a cringeworthy thing. Well, on Lazenby's part it is, but because, you know, you're sort of used to Bond, you know, wooing the girls, but it just kind of feels unnecessary for this film because of the love story and the way they've incorporated that. I thought you didn't need that. Because with Casino Royale, I don't really recall there being... Oh, actually, no, there was at the beginning. But after that, that was before Bond actually met Vesper. So that doesn't really count. Salania, when Bond woos her. But this is after Bond has met Tracy, and... So... Yeah, but... Anyway. Blofeld. Telly Savalas is Blofeld. I'm sorry to... anyone who likes the other two better, but for me, Savalas just has it. He's just so creepy. Like, I can't remember his last name. Like, it's like, when he says to Tracy, like, I can give you everything you want and more. Like, or something like that. Like, but, like the way his voice kind of slowly comes out like this, giving me a sinister feel. Like, yeah, he's very sinister. That's what I love about him. And like, his sort of weird... Not necessarily a rape face, but kind of like a smile. Like, I know that really evil smile is really cool. Irma Bunt is a great henchwoman. I mean, she's no Rosa Klebb, but, you know, she's quite good for what she has to do. And you can tell she's definitely got kind of a domineering presence. And, you know, I think she's quite cool. So Savalas is great as both. Because Donald Pleasance was... terrible as Blofeld, and Charles Grey's not too bad, but we'll save that for the next review. But no, Savalas, I really wish Savalas had come back to do Diamonds Are Forever, because I thought he was a great Blofeld. I don't see why they needed to recast him, whether Savalas didn't have the time to do Diamonds Are Forever, or whether they never asked him, or whether they just felt, because Connery was in the next movie, they probably thought, oh, we might as well change the Blofeld as well, otherwise it would look a bit weird. Maybe that's why they changed him for this film, because they had Donald Pleasance. I mean, thank God they did change him. And the action scenes. The action is amazing. Some of the best action in the series. Like, from, you know, the beach fight, you know, to the bobsleigh fight. Wow, all the action is superb. Like, beach fight is really well choreographed. It's brilliantly, brilliantly done. And there's tension with the action things as well. The fight in the hotel's good. The ski chase is another great highlight. I love that. The car chase is great. Like, every single action sequence, I always look forward to it in this film. The ski chase, the bobsleigh fight is one of the best climaxes in a Bond film ever. Well, it's not the main climax, but one of the best sort of action climaxes in a Bond film. The main climax is the death of Tracy, which is the emotional knockoff. Actually, speaking of that, I would have preferred if they wouldn't have used the Bond theme in the end credits, because it seems a bit bizarre to sort of, when the characters just die and they have the sort of the slow music, you kind of like the back sort of backing track of All the Time in the World. That was a really emotional thing, and then to go da 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 da. Seems a bit bizarre. Like, either have the credits in silence, or continue that music throughout the credits. That's what I would say, but that's just my opinion. Speaking of which, the music is amazing. I mean, I'm actually really glad that they didn't actually have a song on Her Majesty's Secret Service. You know, I mean, how difficult is it to put that in a song? I mean, you know, on Her Majesty's Secret Service, Bond will find something that's not worth it. I don't know, like, it would be terrible. Like, that's, even that was just terrible. But I just love the tune, like, the dun 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 dun. I think the title sequence is great. It's so simple, but it's so effective, and the clips from the previous missions, I guess it's a nice little nod back to the Connery era, but if they didn't have it in the title sequence, it wouldn't have mattered to me. Yeah, no, the title sequence is brilliant. The music is brilliant. It's just a brilliant film. My only problems with the movie are Lazenby. Lazenby is a twit, and he cannot act to save his life. I know that some people like him. I'm talking to you, Alan. but for me, he's just the worst Bond, because his charisma is just all over the place. One minute he's too happy, the next minute he's like, I think we'd all enjoy it more without that. Like, there's no charisma. There's nothing, there's no personality. I mean, well, yeah. But this movie is an absolute masterpiece. And, you know, it goes without saying. Direction is great, editing is great. You know, a couple of the scenes could have been lost, but I'm not complaining. It is a bit too long, I'm not going to lie. I think 2 hours 22 minutes is a stretching it a little bit. I mean, at the time it came out, it was the longest Bond film. I mean, well, not anymore. Casino Royale is now the longest Bond film by, well, it's 2 minutes longer than this film, but it's still, you know, still the longest one. So I'm going to give this movie a 10 out of 10. Really is a masterpiece, and despite my only flaws, you know, which is George Lazenby and the runtime and some of the unnecessary scenes, it's a fantastic movie. And you know, the fact that Lazenby is crap as Bond doesn't detract from the experience. You know, I still think this is a great film, and it is a return to form. Thank you. It's just a shame it follows with yet, I mean, you know, watching the next film after this could suffer a little bit, like Diamonds Are Forever. Yeah. So, the Connery era is not over yet, as he comes back for one more film. For now. For now. He comes back for, in the official series, he comes back for one more film, Diamonds Are Forever, which is the next review. So tune in for my review of Diamonds Are Forever. So yes, what do you think of On Her Majesty's Secret Service? Put your comments down below, let me know. We can talk about it, as if I haven't said enough already. yeah, I really like it. It's a superb film. I like Draco as well, he's a great character. There's a nice little nod to the other missions, like when Bond is about to resign, like he's looking at all the things, and then they play music from the other films, and it's quite nice. And he's like, sorry, Mom. Like, okay, that's a nice little thing for the Connery fans, even if they didn't like Lazenby. Hey-ho. So, yeah, it's a phenomenal piece of cinema. It really is. If you haven't seen it, do watch it. Even if you're not a Bond fan, watch it. Just, you know, if you like a good love story, you'll like this movie. And if you like a good spy thriller but you're not a Bond fan, you probably will like this. Just be prepared to, you know, have, sit through some cringeworthy acting from George Lazenby. Yes, so the end of the Lazenby era. Blimey, I wonder what would have happened if George Lazenby did stay on. Apparently, Lazenby walked out before the movie was even released, like before the movie even premiered. He walked out of the series, so, because he didn't like the direction it was going, apparently. So, as if, you know, he's the guy to sort of ask about Bond. So, yeah. But next week, we return to Connery. Not next week. Next time, we return to Connery for his final outing, which is Diamonds Are Forever. So, stay tuned for that. And, as always, thank you all for watching. As always, I'm Mr. Tarsus 11. See ya.